from Power Director, It Starts in Ski Secret Life. Please welcome your host. She is the first lady of Newcastle gay scene. It is yours truly, It Starts Man.
Here's my key, philosophy. A freak like me just needs infinity.
Doing so, the coronavirus has been extremely worrying for a lot of people, me included, but I'm handling it with extreme caution. So we've just had some breaking news that the Prime Minister has just given a speech and that a lockdown will be in force and people can be allowed to leave home to exercise once a day, and you can only leave the house if you need to travel for work or if you need to go and do shopping. Best thing is to do it first thing tomorrow in the morning. That's from my personal perspective. And also for medication, that the chemists will only allow one or two people at a time in the shop, as we all keep our distance to eliminate this coronavirus. And also all pubs and bars and restaurants have been ordered to close with immediate effect. And this can put a lot of stress and pressure on everyone who are also unemployed. I might not be a fan of politics, but I give Mr. Boris Johnson credit for these measures, despite others protesting that they can't stay at home and have to risk looking after elderly people in care homes as well as disabled people. So if you're choosing to do this, please take as much extra care as you can. And obviously we know that an elderly man from Cramlington has died in hospital after contracting COVID-19. My thoughts are with his family at this sad time. Now, I know it's going to be hard for a lot of you out there, but please, again, only leave home for shopping and work, and that's exactly what I'm doing. Honestly, I was sickened with what I saw on Twitter. Have a look at this.
Who's scared of coronavirus? Don't touch your mouth.
Who would stoop so low and lick a shelf full of products we need in general and potentially contaminate them, you absolutely fucking dirty bastard. I bet your parents will be really proud of you. And I'll tell you what, if I was your parent, I'd be sticking soap right down your throat. I hope you get prosecuted and either fined or in jail, and even both, to be honest with you. But in general, the more we do what the Prime Minister's asking, the quicker the virus will go away from our areas. So this episode is the last in the seventh series, so I'm going to check in with people on this episode. So we've got DJ Drama, who's down in Gateshead. Hello Drama, how are you bearing up? Tell us about what you're doing now.
Well, I do apologise about my hair because I couldn't get a hairdresser's appointment. Who knew? The hairdresser's is closed. But anyway, yeah, I'm good, I'm fine, I'm well and I'm healthy, and I'm doing live streams pretty much nearly every night, just out of sheer boredom, and I want to entertain you guys so you guys aren't bored either. So yes, 8 p.m. every night, DJ Drama Barnes on Facebook. Mixing in the kitchen. And now I'm going to have dinner.
Thanks, matey. Love you lots. Take care. And give Madison my regards as well. Okay, we're going to go down a little further down south and get the return of a familiar face. Everybody loved her when we used to do the news at 10. So I think I'll get her back on just to have a little quick catch up. Hello, Ginny Pet. How are you doing? It's been a while.
David. Hope you're keeping well. Yes, isolating with the cats. So me and the cats are doing, well, what we're supposed to do. Staying at home. And that's it. So yeah, it's a bit lonely, but it's the right thing to do. So take care, pet. Mwah.
Well, that really does bring the end of Series 7. So as I say, stay safe, folks. And I really do think we have a good chance of beating this COVID-19. So from Drama, Ginny and myself, I'll see you all soon. Till the next time, goodbye.